Hello, good evening, everybody. I would at the outset thank ET to give me this opportunity today. Starting with my slides, standardization procedures in an IVF clinic is very, very important for all of us. I think all of us spoke about it so far, and I would just take it forwards from here for what procedures we are doing commonly and how important it is to maintain or standardize our procedures. So what is the aim of standardization? In India, it is a system in order. Like, it is now a requirement to have a standardized system in order to be accredited and to help meet customer demand for improved delivery of our services. So it is the total quality management systems are now being implemented by an increased number of ART clinics. So what are the clinical procedures when a couple comes into our clinics, which we actually do? There are some outpatient procedures as simple as a perspiculum examination, pap smears if required, TVS scan regularly done for all patients, follicle scans, mock ETs, and ERA, that is the endometrial receptivity array test in patients who require it. And inpatients procedures like oocyte pickups, embryo transfers, be it a fresh embryo or a frozen embryo. And in the male side, it is the TESA, TCNP, sir, which we require procedures. Most all of the procedures are minor procedures only. So the associated lab procedures, although this is not the clinical procedure, I've put up a slide here to talk about it, is because we're talking about conventional IVF, ICSI, blastocyst culture, laser-assisted hatching, embryo biopsy for PGS and PGD, because we as clinicians are talking about all of this to each and one of our patients, what they will require as their treatment modality. So what is the aim of the clinic? As everyone spoke now, we have to abide to the guidelines. There are laws pertaining to IVF, so we should strictly abide to them. Safe and ethical practices are very important. So as we are ethical, our patients believe us, and we can explain everything to our patients, right from the diagnosis perspective and the success rates also. And being very transparent has been helping us so long to get good success rate, and also have our patients believing us when they get a positive or a negative out of the program which we do. So points to be considered before starting the IVF clinic in India. As we all spoke, the ICMR has recently finalized national guidelines for the registration of ART clinics. And according to ICMR guidelines, there are three levels of clinics which we can have. So the level one clinics, where we can have just the diagnostics going on, but we can't be using the gametes of the patients over here. We can give them medical treatment. In level two, we can go for the IVF, IUA programs, both husband as well as the donor cycles can be done, but we can't be using the gametes otherwise. In level three, we have to have the registration properly done, and then we have to be using the gametes over there, and it is IVF program, ICSI program, and all those things can be done. What is important for clinical procedures? Ethical practice, it comes as the first thing. Proper diagnosis, always infertility has been underdiagnosed. So when we see a patient coming after 3 years, 5 years, 10 years of married life and not having a baby, we see that they were going to different clinics, but they were not diagnosed of the actual cause of the infertility. So counseling, whether it is procedure or financial, has to be properly given. Appropriate procedure planning has to be done. Informed consent for all procedures has to be done. Adequate manpower to do all these things is very, very important. And we should have sterile, well-equipped operating theatres and best-in-class IVF laboratory as well. So when it comes to the procedures, it is the procedures which requires the SOPs, and documentation and the data creating is very important. The SOPs should be structured in a standardized format, and their distribution must be controlled. Finally, they should be based on documented scientific evidence and require regular updating. So all our clinics should have updating, and they should be looking at what is new in the research and new things coming up which we can help the patients with. So the concept of quality is you plan, as soon as you have a patient, you plan for them, you do the and execute the plan, check whether your procedures were all right. If there was any issues, then you act upon it so that your center is improving day by day. So outpatient procedures, the ambience of the outpatient should be good. Adequate spacing and lighting should be there. Although they are all done in semi-sterile areas, it should be hygienic practices. So we should have well-informed staff, front office to help all this. PCP and DT is a mandatory thing these days, and all of us should be licensed for it because we are doing scans on all our patients. Logistics for in case of ERA and biopsies, where the samples has to be taken. Inpatient procedures, it basically we have to identify our patients and for what procedures we are admitting them. So it may be with the wristbands or stickers or whatever each individual clinic is doing. It should be the identification of the patient and for what procedure they are coming in. Adequate period of fasting if it is done under anesthesia. Well-equipped OPT, skilled OT staff. Consents to be checked in each and every case. And safe procedures has to be planned. Post-op care and follow-up prescriptions has to be followed. So when it comes to the actual procedures inpatient, we have the OPU, that is the oocyte pickup. It is only a daycare procedure. So it need not be that the patient has to be there with us for a long time. Each procedure takes a few minutes. So the patient stays with us for about 3 to 4 hours or max 6 hours. So it should be under a safe anesthesia. It is intravenous anesthesia. Sterile method has to be used. Precision of the procedure is very important. Although it is an ultrasound guided procedure, it should be very accurate. Minimal trauma to the patient, the ovary of the patient. Adequate suction and backup suction tools should be available with us. Maintaining the warmth of the follicular fluid when we are giving it to the lab is very important. And our embryology scientific team to receive the follicular fluid should always be with us. Inpatient procedures like embryo transfer and the thaw embryo transfer, again a daycare procedure, it requires few hours of stay in the center. No anesthesia is required. Again, sterile methods has to be followed. Precision of the procedure is very important. We do it under ultrasound guidance. And the number of embryos we replace is only about 1 to 2. And again, has to be counseled with the couple. Luteal phase support has to be suggested and adequate rest. So most of these patients don't require admissions. They can go back to their houses and have adequate rest. So we advise beta HCG after 2 weeks and follow up the patients thereafter. Other inpatient procedures on men, that is like TESA, TC and PESA, it is again a daycare procedure under safe anesthesia. Sterile methods have to be used. Embryology scientific team should be available with us to check for the sperms under the microscope. Vitrification, if necessary, has to be done immediately. Post-operative pain management and discharge prescriptions have to be given to the patient before they leave. So these are the simple procedures we are doing in most of our IVF clinics, but the embryology team or the scientific team does the rest with the gametes and the embryos. So when we do it, we have to collect the data, which is very important, because we should have an input quality, that is to know the indication for what we have done the cases, age and the protocol start, what is the hormones we have used, number of follicles we had counted, how many eggs did we retrieve, and those things, and the process qualities, like how many M2 sites were available for the injection is very important, and how many embryos developed, how many went up to the cleavage, how many on the second day and third day were good and then arrested, and how many of them became blastocysts. So output quality could be rates of positive human HCG tests to tell us about the positive success rate. Then implantation rate has to be calculated, and how many delivered healthy babies has to be known. freeze-all rate also is very important these days. And serious adverse effect, if anything had happened in the center, has to be notified. So to summarize, there has been an increased demand for transparency pertaining the safety aspects, effectiveness and health outcomes of the our treatments, both from the general public as well as the patients and the regulators. So the important components that make a clinic great are the people, procedure, equipment, and the laboratory design. Recruiting right people is the critical step in setting up the best IVF clinic. An IVF center is only good as the staff it employs, and there is absolute need to ensure consistent and continuous education and training to all our staff also. Thank you very much.